Hey, want to hear the most annoying sound in the world?
What's going on YouTube? It's a fucking nice day and I want to go for a ride. Probably notice there's a bit more noise coming from the back than usual. That's because I decided to dissect the scorpion mufflers. Pulled them apart and I removed all the fiberglass insulation. And now this is what they sound like. I'm not going to run this all the time because I understand it's extremely obnoxious and it does tend to scare people. But listen to this. That is a sound and a half. It's basically like having two big stainless steel garbage cans on the back of the bike. It's like I've got the drummer from AC/DC on one side and the drummer from Slipknot on the other. It's a match made in hell. It's an R9T, I think. So I went to the bike show a week ago, the Motorcycle Expo in Melbourne, and well, I mean, those who follow me on Facebook will know I was pretty unimpressed. I mean, it was just, there were so many manufacturers missing. I mean, you can't have an expo without all the latest and greatest marketing from all the manufacturers, you know. Instead, Honda, Kawasaki, Suzuki, Moto Guzzi, Aprilia, MV Agusta, I mean, they were all missing. The only mainstream Japanese manufacturer that was there was Yamaha, which is alright for me, because, you know, I'm on the XTX, but yeah, they didn't have a bloody XT660 there. They had a Tenere, but they didn't have an XT660R, which they still make. Now, that's pretty piss poor. And they wouldn't let you sit on their bikes unless you asked a bloody salesman. So, you know, Motorcycle Expo, I'd call it more of a motorcycle, I don't know, not even a show. It's just like, it's like going to a bunch of dealerships. It's like going to Car City Ringwood. If you don't know what Car City Ringwood is, it's like, you know, just a basically a big car park full of all different car dealers, used car dealers. But instead for bikes, you know. It was disappointing. They had a bit of, you know, they had a few stunt shows and, you know, dirt bikes doing laps around the showgrounds. That was about it. Some cool old classic bike displays, but, you know, it's not really what you go for, is it? I want to see the latest and greatest from every single, from every manufacturer. you know, I was really looking forward to seeing the new Husqvarna 701 and the 401 prototypes, but they didn't have them there, and that was disappointing to say the least. The Triumph stand was good though. Speed triples and Bonnevilles, Thruxtons, Scramblers, they were all good to look at. The BMW stand was quite good as well.
See the new S1000RR. They're getting rid of the HP4, only going for that one. And yeah, well, that's about it for that. Just riding down Beach Road. Is that a bug in my eye? Ow.
I sort of plan to use these mufflers for the track. I do want to take this bike to a track and see what it can do. I don't necessarily want to crash it, because that would suck. But yeah, I reckon these mufflers would be good for the track, because they're not in the best condition. They're a bit scratched up and they're faded. They're not really shiny anymore, but if I just keep these for a track day, that would be good. I'll run the Delkoviches on the road, because those Delkovich pipes, they sound good. Really love them. Let's go through St Kilda. This is where riding with Tom took my old Balius for a ride with no muffler. Scared the entirety of St Kilda with its awesomeness.
It sounded like there was an F1 car hooning down the street. But it's just a little 250 going 40 k's an hour.